Well, good afternoon, good evening, depending on where you are. Welcome to the North Bay Business Journal's 8th Annual Wine, Spirits, and Beer Awards Industry Awards. Thank you very much for being with us here this evening. We started doing virtual events back in April when we realized live events were not possible because we believed it was important to bring people together and continuing to honor outstanding work. And this is no exception here today. Again, my name is Brad Bollinger. I'm the publisher of the journal. Welcome. Thank you for being with us. We started these awards 8 years ago because, and we added spirits and beer a couple of years ago because we thought the North Coast deserved its own awards program. And we did this in collaboration with the Wine Industry Network, George Christie, and Kim Battenport, because they were doing what we also thought the North Coast industry deserved, and that was to have its own trade show. Can't do that this year, although I just came off a meeting in which it was announced they do plan to do it next year. So congratulations to them. This is a very special place we call the North Bay, and we think it deserves its own awards. And apparently a lot of people agree with us because we had the best response to nominations this year than in the 8 years that I had been doing this. We'll have 22 companies and individuals recognized here. They're doing all sorts of fascinating things in the brewing industry, in the spirits industry, and in the wine industry. And as you'll see how it's going to go here in a few minutes, we'll say a little bit about each award winner, and then we've invited each of them, if they want to submit a 20-second video to answer the question, what is your message you want to get out to the community? And there's just a lot of very heartfelt things you're going to hear and very exciting things that are happening. So I want to thank the Wine Industry Network for being our partner again here this year. I remember having a call with George Christie here several months ago and said, hey, should we just not do this? And within about a couple of minutes, we decided absolutely we're going to do this. And here we are today. I want to thank the individuals and the companies that nominated. I like to say around the Business Journal, you can't have good winners without good nominations. And please, before we start into our awards, I want to thank our sponsors who made this possible and in many ways helped you out in your day-to-day operation of your business. As you'll hear from George Christie, both on the professional services side, of course, and then also in the supplier side. So please join me in thanking our presenting sponsors here tonight, BPM and the Frank Family Vineyards. Thank you to them. And then a special thank you to our the Spirited Magazine, which is part of the Sonoma Media Investments, which owns us, the Press Democrat, Sonoma Magazine, Federal Farmers Courier, Sonoma Index Tribune, La Prensa, and of course, all the associated websites. And then of course, as I mentioned, the Wine Industry Network. Because of their support, we can present this event free here tonight. And then of course, and I wanna welcome as our underwriter for these awards and this virtual event, Comerica Bank. Thanks to Mike Silva, Chris Thompson, and all of their great team there at Comerica Bank for supporting this here tonight. If you know somebody at any of those sponsors, you know, wave to them, send them an email, thank them because we're here because they continue to support us as we moved on to this, this virtual platform. So once again, thank you for being with us. The way this is going to work, I'm going to present some awards. We also have some of our supporters presenting awards. Of course, we'll have the Winovation Awards about halfway through. So it's now my pleasure to present the first award to in the brewery CEO category to Jeff Ottoboni, who is the Chief Executive Officer of North Coast Brewing Company in Fort Bragg. He was asked, how did he get into the industry? He said, well, I was in the wine business, holding a variety of executive positions for over 30 years, and then he transitioned into beer about a year ago. North Coast Brewing Company is a pioneer in the craft brewing industry and differentiates itself as a B corporation with a focus just not on profits, but on community, the environment, and people. It's donated substantial sums of money to a variety of endeavors, including music, music education, and marine mammal science. Most recently, they partnered with UC Davis to fund an endowment for a diversity-based scholarship to the Master Brewers program. Their mission statement, making the world a better place, one pint at a time. Couldn't have said it better myself. Congratulations to Jeff Ottobani of North Coast Brewing Company. Let's hear a little bit from Jeff.
First of all, I'm honored to be an award recipient this evening on behalf of the North Coast Brewing Company and the craft brewing industry. 2020 has been an extremely challenging year, and yet I think it could be one of great opportunity as well. It has given us all the chance to communicate better in different forums and to rework our business operations in ways that will benefit us all down the road, perhaps even in ways that we don't yet foresee. We are never promised anything in business, and this may just be the wake-up call we need to really receive this message and act upon it in a positive and constructive way.
Congratulations to Jeff and Northwest Brewing. What a great message. You're not guaranteed anything in business. So what we're doing now is we're going to be with us for as we move forward in business. Our next award goes to Ronald Du Preez, who is in the Winery Custom Crush category. He's a general manager and head winemaker at Sugarloaf Crush here in Santa Rosa. He's a graduate with a dual degree in viticulture and enology, and he became involved while at university in clonal research, doing a school's experimental farm, where he was responsible for crafting over 100 wines. After graduation, he came to California to join Jordan Vineyards as a harvest intern, and over the next 12 years, he held increasing positions of responsibility at Jordan, ultimately becoming associate winemaker under Rob Davis. And he traveled extensively as a national spokesperson for the luxury brand while simultaneously managing the 1,200-acre Jordan viticulture program. Today, he's thrilled to be part of the founding team at Sugarloaf Crush, the North Bay's premier custom crush company, founded in 2016. And since founding Sugarloaf Crush, he has helped redefine what small lot precision custom crush looks like at Sugarloaf. And their key accomplishments include a build out of a gorgeous hospitality center with private suites for indoor and outdoor engagement with guests. He mentioned what changes he expects to see in the industry in the next 5 years. He says there's been a shift to either much larger lot production or a shift to much smaller production with very little in between. He was asked, you know, how have you responded to the challenges and opportunities of the pandemic? He said they anticipate that this challenging time will help correct an oversupply in the industry and better prepare brands to engage with fans digitally and sell more through the DTC channel. And as these benefits accrue to clients, they anticipate a similar improvement to their business. Please join me in congratulating Ronald Du Preez of Sugarloaf Crush. Ronald?
To the wine community, 2020 has taught us to think differently, to be more nimble, to be more creative in so many different ways. What it ultimately has shown us is the perseverance of Sonoma County and the members of the community here to be strong, to be resilient during tough times. To all of you and all of our clients at Sugarloaf Crush, we wish you a happy Christmas season and a happy new year. Cheers to 2021.
Congratulations, Ronald. It's now my pleasure to present the next award. This is one of my favorites this year, and we've got a great video coming up, to Tom Gamble, who's a vintner and farmer at Gamble Family Vineyards in St. Helena. This is a special award for environmental restoration. He says, my forefathers began farming in the Napa Valley in 1916. He's a third generation Napa farmer. He purchased his first vineyard in 1981 and have been farming vineyards for 40 years. He is the first in his family to grow grapes commercially, and he cares deeply about the land and sustainable agriculture. While he continues to farm for many small producers, he started his own winery Gamble Family Vineyards in 2005. In the early 2000s, he helped draft the original programming for both the Napa Green and fish-friendly farming certifications. His family and team have led to the restoration of the Napa River, not only with land donations, but with over more than 20 years of advocacy for the community's watersheds. He's also encouraged neighbors to participate. Consequently, the Napa River is the most intact river system in the Bay Area, as demonstrated by increasing populations of Chinook salmon and steelhead trout. Please join me, and I want to mention one more thing about Tom. He continues to advocate for traditions used by his father, who practiced vegetation management and other fire mitigation techniques, which are so important now. And they're thankful that they survived the LNU complex fire and glass fire, but wants to continue to support the wine industry and the environment. So please join me in congratulating Tom Gamble. We're gonna hear a little bit from him.
These redwood trees burned in 2017. They survive and sprout anew. This untouched riparian area along the Napa River is no longer an island, but part of 30 miles of voluntary river restoration. These examples renew my spirit, and I hope yours. After this year's disasters, the rebuilding and restoration ahead of us is daunting, yet we will persevere and we will build back better and more sustainably. Don't stop believing.
Well, congratulations, Tom, well deserved. The next award goes to Todd Graff in the Napa County Winemaker category. He is the general manager and winemaker for Frank Family Vineyards in Calistoga. Congratulations to you. Born and raised in Petaluma, he was drawn to winemaking at a young age. He enrolled in an introductory wine course while attending Santa Rosa Junior College before graduating from UC Davis with a degree in plant science and viticulture in 1984. He circled the world after graduations, working in Germany, France, and Australia, and he returned to the Napa Valley in 1987 to work as assistant winemaker at Stag's Leap Winery. And from 1990 to 95, he was assistant winemaker and vineyard manager at Schramsberg Vineyards. And after 20 years of working as a winemaker in every corner of the world, he landed at Calistoga's Frank Family Vineyards in 2003, and he says he has never looked back. He says he's played a role in Frank Family's steady growth over the past 18 vintages, and it's been a joy of his to apply his expertise in both making still and sparkling wines for the Frank Family portfolio. The winery's reputation as a world-class producer of Cabernet Sauvignon and Chardonnay has just grown. He directed the construction of Frank Family's new state-of-the-art winery in 2008, closely with proprietor Rich Frank, worked with him on the acquisition and redevelopment of Benjamin Vineyard in Rutherford in 2012. And in 2014, helped the Frank Family receive the Napa Green certification for both land and winery. And in 2012 and 2017, the Frank Family was recognized for its across-the-board success and received Winery of the Year accolades from Connoisseur's Guide to California Wine. He was asked, what changes have you noticed in your industry in the last 5 years? He said, the manpower of our small and mighty sales force around the country is our winery's strength. And Frank Family has become a nationally distributed and well-respected brand because of the forethought to invest in an excellent team and our outstanding marketing and distribution relationships. How have you responded to the growing competition in the craft spirits? He says he welcomes the emergence of alternative drinks and view them as a complement, not a substitute for traditional beverages like beer and wine. And he anticipates the current hard seltzer or craft spirits drinker will be introduced to wine down the road, creating a stepping stone to one category to the other. Finally, how has responded to the challenges of the virus-influenced economic situation we're all in? In the market, we made a swift transition from on-premise to off-premise sales And at the winery, we adjusted in-person sales to e-commerce, and they have experienced a 500% increase in online sales from last year. Finally, how has the North Bay wildfires and the power shutoffs impacted you? It says, winemaking as always has its challenges, but our jobs are fun and we love what we do. Sadly, the wildfires in recent years has taken some of that fun away. It can also be an emotional toll on our team, but regardless what nature throws at us, we're ready and our outlook is always positive. Congratulations to Todd Graff. We're gonna hear a little bit from him.
Good afternoon from Frank Family Vineyards. We would like to thank North Bay Business Journal for selecting us, winemaker Napa County. And this 2020 vintage has been a challenging year to say the least, but I know we'll get through it stronger than ever and want to raise a glass to all the winemakers out there. Cheers.
Well, congratulations once again. It's now my pleasure to introduce you Jamie Emerson Heary, who's a senior manager at BPM, to present our next award.
Kathleen Inman is the owner and winemaker of Inman Family Wines. Kathleen was born and raised in Napa, and although her family was not involved in the wine industry at the time, her love of wine was discovered at a wine class at UC Santa Barbara. The wine industry also brought her to her now husband, Simon. After living 15 years in England, they moved back to Sonoma County, where they started the winery in year 2000. She's proud to say that since 2004, before rosé was popular, that she's been a major advocate for premium vineyard-driven rosé, which she treats every bit as seriously as other flagship wines they have. In talking with her recently, she's mentioned that a key area of emphasis for her has been mentoring women in the wine industry as a whole, that historically has been very male-dominated, not just here in Sonoma County, but all over the world. She's proud to say that she's helped several women navigate through their careers and even start their own wine brands. When asked what her biggest challenge was recently, her obvious response was navigating through the COVID-19 pandemic. In early February, she was the first to adopt virtual tastings, an idea that she even had back in 2007, a bit ahead of its time. Since then, she's held nearly 200 virtual tastings and doesn't plan to stop that post-pandemic. Join me in recognizing Kathleen of Inman Family Wines.
Hi, I'm Kathleen Inman from Inman Family Wines. Thank you, North Bay Business Journal, for this award. The pandemic has been a challenge for all of us here in the Russian River Valley. I know it's been a challenge both professionally and personally for many of us. But I think that our region that makes some of the best wines in the world will bounce back. And many of us have already been able to change our businesses, pivoting to different products and different ways of doing business. And I think that we will be all the stronger for it. Thank you again for the award.
Well, thank you, Jamie. Congratulations, Kathleen. Well deserved. It's now my pleasure to present the next award to Hanson Spirits and Chris Hanson and his brother Brandon Hanson were influenced by, this is in the distillery category. It goes to the company Hanson of Sonoma Distillery. They were influenced by the surge in the craft brewery movement and the art of distillation. And they decided to make a 100% certified organic and gluten-free vodka from grapes. Values that were ingredient-based and more in the food world than in the spirits world. They have grown their wholesale distribution channel into most of the United States, which is quite incredible. COVID has drastically changed their business, as it has all businesses. Our production has never been shut down, but early on, a tasting room shut down. They focused on making hand sanitizer, and they donated it to many to first responders, hospitals, and the local community. Thank you. We've focused on creating new products and selling our products curbside to go, and we've taken this time to improve our tasting room offerings and experiences with our new outside tasting area and are offering full meals with the extraordinary chef Martin. Lastly, we appreciate everything he wanted to say, everything the firefighters, police, and first responders do in response to these crises that we've gone through. Still, we are happy to be in Sonoma and wouldn't want to be anywhere else and feel good about our future in Sonoma. Please join the Business Journal and Comerica, our co-host here today, to congratulate Hanson of Sonoma Distillery. We'll hear a little bit from them.
Hi, I'm Alana Hanson.
And I'm Chris Hanson, and we're from Hanson of Sonoma Distillery. We want to thank North Bay Business Journal for voting us Distillery of the Year this year.
You know, it means a lot to have support of our community during this time. COVID has been really challenging for a lot of us, but, you know, with the support of our growers and our partners and North Bay Business Journal, it's helped us get through some of these more challenging times, and we're really grateful. So thank you for giving us this award.
Thank you.
Congratulations to Hanson of Sonoma. The next award goes to Ryan Hodgins, who's the winemaker and director of operations for Fell Wines. This is in the winemaker category for Mendocino County. He says a love of food and cooking combined with a biology degree led him to get his master's in viticulture and enology at UC Davis. His entire career has focused on crafting great Pinot Noir and Chardonnay from Mendocino County's Anderson Valley. As a means of researching the topic for a master's thesis, Pinot Noir tannins in the Willamette Valley, he got his first hands-on vineyard experience while working harvest at Witness Tree Vineyard in Salem, Oregon. And upon graduating in 2004, he spent a year gaining experience in other regions at wineries such as Acacia Vineyard in Napa. And he was the harvest enologist and Krishna Valley Winery in India, where he served as visiting winemaker. In 2005, he returned to the United States and accepted a full-time position as assistant winemaker and viticulturalist at Hansel Vineyards, a role that helped him hone his expertise in Pinot and Chardonnay. And while at Hansel, he also worked on the founding consulting winemaker for Brego Cellars in Anderson Valley. The lead family acquisition of Brego Cellars, now Fell, in 2009 allowed him to be full-time winemaker, and the lead family purchased Savoy Vineyard, a benchmark vineyard in Anderson Valley, which he oversees the farming. Anderson Valley, he said, is still relatively unknown fine wine growing region, but over the last 5 years, Fell has garnered numerous high scores in the upper 90s from multiple publications, helping raise the profile of the region. And additionally, Pinot from the Savoy Vineyard continues to be some of the most sought after fruit in the Anderson Valley. He was asked, what have you noticed in your industry in the last 5 years? He says the drought has affected California since 2014, has led them to focus on water use in both the vineyard and winery. And in the vineyards, they are planting drought tolerant rootstocks that allow them to dry farm without irrigation. As he's responded to, new entries into the market, such as hard seltzers, he says, our focus remains on crafting outstanding wines that connect our customers to both a vintage and a place. Wine has a unique ability to reflect the growing season of the vintage and the vineyard where grapes are grown. Congratulations to Brian Hodgins of Fell Vineyards. We're going to hear a little bit from him.
Hi, I'm Ryan Hodgins. I'm the winemaker for Fell Wines. We're a small producer that specializes in Pinot Noir and Chardonnay from Mendocino County's Anderson Valley. I was asked to say a few words during these trying times, and as things are difficult out there, the best advice I can offer is to enjoy a good glass of Pinot Noir when you can, and please wear your mask.
Great advice on enjoying a glass of wine. Congratulations to Ryan again and to Phil Wines. Our next award goes to Clay Morrison, who is the president of Morrison Wines in the winery owner category for Sonoma County. He started Morrison Wines in 1988 in response to the consolidation in the industry and the incredible vineyards that they were farming. And they have never looked back after that. How has your company influenced the industry in the last 5 years? He says that I hope that our biggest influence has been our focus on community by getting involved in trade organizations and serving local nonprofits. It's easy to sit on the sidelines and complain. It's something altogether different to really try to affect change. And this past year, he had co-chaired the Sonoma County Wine Auction with two other incredible wineries. The auction is the largest charitable event in Sonoma County and has put more than $40 million back into the community. He serves on the board of directors of the Sonoma County Vintners Foundation, and he is a founding member of the Down Syndrome Association, North Bay, and with his wife serves on the board of Becoming Independent. He continues to host Project Zen with Charlie Palmer and has raised over $1 million to date for the Down Syndrome Association of the North Bay. I should say that he co-serves on the Down Syndrome Association North Bay with his wife. Asked how is he responding to growing competition from craft spirits and other alternatives, he says hard seltzers have exposed a missed opportunity in winemaking. They have positioned themselves as low calorie and healthy alternative to wine, when the truth is wine is about as natural and as healthy of an alcoholic product there is. Our response has been ever greater transparency to our customers about our vineyard practices and winemaking protocols. We have a truly consumable product that is not only an encapsulation of place and time, but has just one ingredient, that would be grapes. Asked about the impact of the pandemic, he says it's been very tough, but it's caused them to focus on new sales channels, and year over year sales are comparable to last year's. Congratulations. The utilization of Zoom and other virtual platforms, he says, is here to stay. While he hopes that the hospitality industry in Sonoma County has a swift rebound, they will continue to use the virtual platform to support the three-tier sales channels. And it finally says, and all the fires and power shutoffs, he says, we remain bullish on Sonoma County and especially Healdsburg, where they are located. Congratulations to Clay Morrison. It's now my pleasure to welcome George Christie, who is the president and CEO of the Wine Industry Network, and Kim Battenfort to present the Winovation Awards for 2020. Please welcome George Christie.
Hey everyone, George Christie here with Wine Industry Network. Welcome to the Wine Industry Network Innovation Award presentation, or Winovation Awards as we call them. Now, this is a program that's been going on for 7 years. It's something that we developed to help celebrate the vendors out there that make incredible contributions to our industry. You know, the wines and the winemakers, deservedly so, get the lion's share of attention, certainly from the consumer side. But the truth of the matter is a lot of the innovation that occurs really happens on the vendor side. It's those companies that are out there working with our wineries, our winemakers, our vineyard managers, helping to solve some of the problems they have, whether it has to do with creating more efficiencies or just making a quality impact or making the job just a little bit easier. Each one of our winners is going to get a nice trophy like this that they can put in their lobby or in their office as a way to remember the award. And I will tell you that every year we narrow it down to five winners. It's never an easy process because there's some incredible talent out there. But if necessity is the mother of invention, certainly we have that in 2020 in spades. So this year was actually even more difficult, but I will tell you that the five winners we selected were certainly incredibly deserving, incredibly talented, and made some huge contributions to our industry. Now to make the presentations, I want to introduce Kim Battenfort. Kim is the editor for Wine Industry Advisor. He plays a leading role in the selection process. He works very closely with these vendors. And I'm going to hand it off to Kim to introduce this year's winners and hand off their new trophy for their lobby. Kim, I'll let you take it from here.
Thank you, George. This will be the eighth year that we are honoring wine industry innovators, and each year we've been impressed with the ingenuity, commitment, and expertise these companies show in taking on problems that plague the wine industry and even creating new opportunities for a better product, a stronger business, and even in many cases, a better world. We'll be awarding five of these companies today, and I will endeavor to give you a short idea of what each of these innovations are about, but alas, in this short time, I probably won't be able to do them justice. So if you want to know more, visit wineindustryadvisor.com/winovation and reach out to these companies if you think their innovations can help your business. Now, the first 2020 Winovation Award goes to ATP Group for air mixing MI technology developed by Parsec. This technology marries physics with chemistry to manage the mark cap. Inside the tank, algorithmically controlled air injections create disruptive waves, resulting in a homogeneous mixing. This technique reduces the vinification time by obtaining an effective and selective extraction of the entire cap. The waves are customized to the size of the tank, and one notable advantage is that this is effective even in very large tanks and tanks of irregular shapes that can make conventional methods of cap management difficult. Here to accept the award for ATP Group is Max Buani, Vice President, Enological Process Sales. Congratulations, Max.
Thank you very much, Kim. It's a honor for us to receive this award and being a partner of Parsec to introducing this system in the US has been an amazing project. So we're extremely proud of the success we received so far and of course of receiving this award. Thank you very much.
The next award goes to California Soda Company for their chlorine dioxide tank sanitation mister. This mister creates a chemical fog inside the tank using 98% less water than traditional sanitation methods while obtaining equal or better results. That's not only less water, but less time, less chemistry, and less waste, which means better for the winery, better for all of us. Here to accept the award is California Soda CEO, Ron Hink. Congratulations, Ron.
Thank you, Kim. I appreciate it. I want to thank Wine Industry Network and their staff for recognizing the importance of this new method as far as wine sanitation. Also want to thank Bob Tracy of BevTrack, who with his microbiology background proved that this method works in the wine industry for saving water and labor and reducing the amount of chemistry used. Also, Marcus Riddle of Simi Vineyards, the cellar master, he put together a SOP and put a lot of time and effort into proving this, that this works in the wine cellar for sanitation. And then also Selective Microtechnologies, who developed the chlorine dioxide method I use. It's a unique method producing the chlorine dioxide in a safe, easy to use manner. So anyways, thanks, Cam. I appreciate it. See you soon.
The next award goes to Contech for their Golo de-alkalization technology. There's a growing consumer trend towards healthy living, which often means that they reach for low or no alcohol beverages. This technology allows breweries and wineries to reduce the amount of alcohol in their beverage without sacrificing product quality. A single pass through the Golo system can reduce the alcohol content to 0.05% while retaining 100% of the product's original aromas and flavor compounds. Here to accept the award is Contech CEO Jerome Nathan. Congratulations, Jerome.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you, Vinnovation, for this award. We're very excited about Golo technology and to see it recognized as such. We strongly believe that it is the next generation of equipment that's going to allow a whole new generation of de-alkalized product on the market. And it's really rewarding to see it appreciated by Vinnovation and hopefully by our customers too. Thank you.
The next award goes to Livery Vino for rethinking how wine can be shipped safe and cost effectively. Their shipping cooler can keep wine safe and cool for up to 5 days, eliminating the need for weather holds and allowing for the use of ground transportation, which is both cheaper and greener. Their shipping cooler can be reused multiple times, and at the end of its life cycle, up to 95% of the materials are recyclable. It's better for the winery, it's better for the world. Here to accept the award is Livery Senior Vice President of Global Development, Brian Jacoby. Congratulations, Brian.
Kim, thank you so much. I'd just like to take a quick moment to recognize a few folks. First, I want to thank the Wine Industry Network. your tireless efforts to connect the business community, to share a wealth of knowledge and provide a forum that brings people together is absolutely amazing. So thanks for all that you do. I also want to make sure I get a chance to recognize the amazing efforts of the teams at Livery, especially our design, engineering, and product development teams. They've envisioned a whole new market and have done so much to help bring it to life. And finally, our Livery executive group, our board of directors, and our ownership, the Richardson family, for continuing to aspire our efforts and give us all the support we need to make this possible. So thank you so much on behalf of everyone at Livery. Thank you.
The final award goes to Interactive for their Preference Pro automated marketing solution. With Preference Pro, Interactive has taken some of the world's most powerful email marketing technology and made it accessible and customized to wineries. The technology combines automation and artificial intelligence to ensure that the right message is delivered at the right time to the right customer, which improves brand connection and grows sales. Early adopters of Preference Pro have seen opening and response rates increase by 40 to 50%. Interactive has also made sure with APIs that they integrate with existing point of sale systems so that you can use all your data to make sure you can create a customized, personalized experience for your customer. Here to accept the award is Interactive CEO and founder, Brian St. Amant. Congratulations, Brian.
Thank you so much for this tremendous honor. I accept this award on behalf of the wineries and inventors who helped us create Preference Pro, the industry's first automated wine marketing platform. I hope this recognition raises awareness about the ways digital marketing can help our industry move forward. And I firmly believe that with innovation and determination, our best is yet to come.
Congratulations again to all the winners, and thank you for advancing the wine industry with your innovations. For more information about these innovative solutions, please visit wineindustryadvisor.com/winnovation. Now back to you, Brad.
Well, thank you so much, Kim and George. It's just amazing, these innovators that are out there. Really kind of differentiates our wine industry here, the combination of tradition and quality and innovative practices. So once again, thank you for bringing recognition where it's so due. So we're a little over halfway in presenting our awards here. So thank you for being with us. We've still got some very exciting award winners to highlight. And this next one is particularly amazing in what they're doing with Anderson Valley Brewing Company. And this is award goes to Kevin McGee, who's the CEO at Anderson Valley Brewing Company in Boonville in Mendocino County. And he, in his profile, he said, "I suppose the point of no return was in 2007 when he turned his garage into a bonded commercial brewery, the Healdsburg Beer Company, and started turning out 30-gallon batches of beer. And his family bought Anderson Valley Brewing Company in December of 2019. And while he's only been at AVBC for a year, he spent the last 13 years single-handedly operating the one-barrel brew house he designed and built and selling small batch cask ales out of his car to local bars and restaurants. The super small production meant that every pint was extremely important and forced him to focus his attention to detail and quality. And it was an effective crucible," he said, "in developing his brewing skills." So his career has taken a winding path, but in retrospect, it feels, he said in his profile, "like I've been spending the last few decades preparing for my family to acquire Anderson Valley Brewing Company. He's been working in alcoholic beverages for just about 20 years. When he founded Healdsburg Brewing Company, he was spending his days at Jackson Family Wines as just Jackson's legal aide, legal counselor, and spending his nights and weekends brewing. He's an attorney and initially worked as a prosecutor in San Francisco and San Mateo counties, where he specialized and taught gang violence prosecution trial tactics and law. When he left to enter civil practice, he developed a number of wineries and clients and started learning the business aspects of alcohol production, et cetera. So following Jess's passing, he developed a dynamic consulting and operating partner business, during which time he served as CEO of a wine hospitality focused private equity firm. As he said, his consulting work focused on generally fixing business problems and crisis management, mergers and acquisitions, corporate development, and strategizing and executing growth strategies so they don't become problems that then need to be fixed. His family's acquisition of Anderson Valley Brewing Company was a product of a long search and even longer effort to find something that the family could hold on long-term as a multi-generational business. And Anderson Valley Brewing was precisely what they were looking for, a pioneering craft brewery with deep authenticity and a long history of top quality beer. He says, this is my last job and I plan on doing it for the next 25 to 30 years and then passing the business along to the family. Anderson Valley has a long history. It was founded in 1987 and again has a long history of quality. Big accomplishments this year is further developing and leave no trace brewing. And this involves expanding their solar power to increase generation to cover 100% of their power needs. And they recently installed a nitrogen generator, which harvests nitrogen gas from the ambient air and allows us to use it for CO2 or production gas. It replaces 70 to 80% of their CO2 usage. And for packaging in 2021, I'm going on a little bit more because this is such a great story. We are moving to 100% aluminum packaging and eliminating all plastic from our packaging. During the time of COVID, we've also worked to strengthen our staffing and staff and have actually added headcount, most notably adding 4 new sales staff and making good on our commitment to maintain all our employees and their compensation and benefits at pre-COVID levels. Incredible. Further, we also are in the process of renovating the tap room and grounds and will be reopening as a family and dog-friendly 30-acre beer park and with further improvements to the 18-hole disc golf course. What fun. How have you responded to the challenges and opportunities of the pandemic? Our main focus this year has been on expanding our distributor relationships and staffing up our sales team in the western parts of the country, which has resulted in 34% increase in offsite sales. They've also focused on promoting key products, shifted their company culture to leave no trace, and supported our local community through donating a portion of beer sales to the Community Foundation of Mendocino. And what adjustments and initiatives do you think will continue past the pandemic? Basically all of them, he said. All the decisions made this year, whether the pandemic played a role or not, were initiatives that needed to be made for the long-term health of the business. Please join the Business Journal and our co-host, the Comerica Bank, in congratulating Kevin McGee of Anderson Valley.
Hi, I'm Kevin from Anderson Valley Brewing Company. If I have a message, it's to be alert for opportunities to support the people around you. These times have taken an enormous mental health toll from everyone. And we are privileged as an industry to be considered essential and allowed to continue operating. But the humans that are responsible for all of that work are all struggling in their own rights. There are some people that are more stoic about it than others, but there isn't a single person who hasn't been challenged this year. So I'd say be alert for ways that you can support the people around you, be patient, be kind, and we'll all get through this together.
Well, congratulations and best wishes on your future there at Anderson Valley Brewing. It's now my pleasure to present the next award. This is in the winery, Napa Valley Winery Owner category, to Scott Miller, who's the proprietor and founder of Amloy Wines in Yountville. He and his wife, Sharon Wirtz, had found great success in their professional lives together. And they wanted to start a new chapter and they have focused on the historical preservation and philanthropy. And that's what this is about, philanthropy. Believing in playing forward our good fortune, the couple established the Wirtz Miller Foundation in 2016. They also purchased a dilapidated 19th century estate in Loudoun County, Virginia, called Summa. And Sharon and Scott have been in restoring this beautiful home as it was remembered as a place from their early years. Brick by brick endeavor, they were able to restore it over a 2-year period. So Sonoma became their home. They also have a home in Yountville, which we'll get to here in a second. And it was during these nights that he first broached the idea they'd sit out on the porch at this home that he first broached the idea of starting Amloy Wines, a wine brand where 100% of the profits would go to the Wirtz Miller Foundation to support what they refer to as pillars of a thriving community: education, culture, historic preservation, health, and opportunity. Amloy is a Selma written backwards, a nod to seeing our own reflections and the good we could do in our next chapter, as well as to the artwork on their labels, et cetera. Sharon and Scott have a home in Yountville, as I mentioned, so they've always had a strong connection to the Napa Valley, and then we have Amloy Wine. So the first vintage will be in 2021, and they plan to invest 100% of the proceeds in the wines back to the Wirtz Miller Foundation. As I mentioned, they've already committed $10 million to what they refer to as those pillars of a thriving community. They said, we know that Napa Valley wine at the highest level of farming and winemaking continues to gain momentum. This is how they see the industry changing and adjusting. We looked around and just did not see anyone making aspirational wines for the greater good and saw an opportunity here. And that's why they launched this wine brand. So congratulations to Scott Miller and Sharon, of course, for this award. And let's hear a little bit from Scott.
First, I'd like to thank you for this honor. I truly, truly appreciate it. One of the reasons that we started Amloy Wines was to bring together people in a very special way. My wife, Sharon, and I have close ties to the Napa Valley and a home in Yountville. All the proceeds from the sale of Amloy Wines will go back into the communities in which we live through our nonprofit Wirtz Miller Foundation. With my friends, the extraordinary winemaker, Philippe Melka, and the renowned reflectionist artist, J.D. Miller, we've crafted a Bordeaux-style wine dedicated to the greater good. Now, we know Napa's resilient, so hang in there. And very soon, we hope we'll be together so we can share a glass of Amloy Wines.
Well, congratulations to Scott and Sharon. We look forward to the years ahead. It's now my pleasure to present a supplier award to Vino Pro here in Brunner Park in Sonoma County. Vino Pro partners with wineries to grow their direct-to-consumer wine sales, very important right now, and white club sales over the phone. They build deep relationships with their customers while on the phone and have sold over $100 million in wine since 2008 for their winery partners. What is something about your company that people would be surprised to learn? Most people think we get told, take me off the list a lot when we make phone calls, but people love to talk about wine and hear from their winery. Their direct do not call rate is 0.5%, and this is less than a typical winery's email unsubscribe rate. Most wineries have continued to invest in technology. This is what's going to change over the next 5 years in upgrading their e-commerce systems. With 3 full-time programmers, VinoPro invested in integrations to better manage their telesales programs with the major e-commerce systems, including eSeller, WineDirect, AMS, and VinSuite, to name just a few. What are some projects that your company is working on since COVID-19? Our growth has been astronomical. We are heavily focused on hiring and training and growing our sales team while building tools, systems, and training to support our online workforce. So please congratulate Vino Pro, and here to talk a little bit about it is their general manager, Donnie Varner. Donnie?
Congrats to the whole team at Vino Pro. Thanks for all of your hard work. This is for you. My name is Donnie Varner, GM of Vino Pro. You know, we started Vino Pro in 2008 during the worst financial crisis in our lifetimes, and between wildfires and floods and earthquakes And now this pandemic, there's always going to be circumstances that try and prevent you from winning and prevent you from being successful. And it's important to pivot and be resourceful. Don't panic. Think about how you can be creative to get through the situation and be better off when you come out of the other side. I've heard of wineries, for example, that are doing date night where you can pick up wine and your dinner at the same time. We're a resilient community. Be creative. We'll get through it.
Congratulations, Vino Pro. Great message, Donnie. Again, congratulations. Next, I'd like to welcome Alicia Pope, who's tax director for BPM, to present our next award.
Hi, this is Alicia Pope of BPM, and I'm here to present the co-founders of Craft Beverage Award to Hunter Wade and Jolie Devoto of Golden State Cider. It is my pleasure to be working with them for their compliance and consulting needs over the last few years. They've been a client of BPM since about 2014, a couple of years after they started the company in 2012. They have grown this company from a small local-based company with a small distribution channel just in the Bay Area to now busting at the seams distribution channel throughout California and focusing mainly on the West Coast. As you'll see that they've had significant increases over the years in production. If you just look at their apple tonnage, they've gone from doing just over 1,000 tons a year to over 5,000 in about 3 years' time. So their cidery business has really expanded. And even with COVID in 2020, they've seen a really big uptick in cider sales, as well as now their apple brandy that's on the market. So I just think it's great that we've got, you know, hometown Sebastopol group that's really stuck to their roots and through all of their blood, sweat, and tears have poured everything they have into this evolving company and have made their dreams a reality. And it's a pleasure working with them. And I wish them all the best this holiday season as they continue to grow and expand this company into what their dream is now. So congratulations, Hunter, Jolie, and the team at Golden State Cider.
Well, thank you, Alicia. And once again, congratulations to Hunter and Jolie and Golden State Cider for your great success bootstrapping that company. And we're just so pleased to see you be successful. Congratulations again. It's now my pleasure to present the next award. This would be in a sparkling wine winemaker, and it goes to Manveer Sandhu, who is director of winemaking at Rack and Riddle Custom Wine Services in Healdsburg. How did you get into the industry? His entry started with a circumstance of convenience, he says. While job hunting as a student at UC Davis, he came across a laboratory technician position, started there. He worked in the lab and vineyard, and taking a few V&E classes ignited a passion in him to and a new direction for his future. And so after graduating from UC Davis, he pursued a winemaking career with his first venture be at Delicato Family Wines. And then finally he found himself at Gallo, I think at one point in Delicato and E&J Gallo's Modesto facility. And having a firm grasp on laboratory production, it was time to forge ahead in his winemaking career path, joining Rack and Riddle in 2011 as assistant winemaker laboratory manager. How has your company influenced the industry in the last 5 years? Their key accomplishments. Rack and Riddle is not only one of the largest producers of sparkling wines in California and the US, but a leader in custom crush facilities for both sparkling and still winemaking. The biggest change he has noticed in the industry is the pace and demand of production. That time between each harvest has progressively compressed, and the need to start planning earlier for capital projects and improvements in harvest preparedness has become a priority. How is the North Bay wildfires and power shutoffs affecting the outlook of your business? We realized pretty quickly that the challenges of seasonal wildfires and power shutoffs was likely to be something that will be continue and to deal with, we have to deal with in the future. That's a theme that all of these winners here are preparing and getting better prepared. They have added additional systems in place like pressure nitrogen gassing system for wine tanks and a cellar-wide bank chilling system to keep wine temperature controlled and nitrogen gassed if the winery is inaccessible during wildfires. Congratulations to Manveer Sandhu. We're going to hear from him now.
Hello to my friends and colleagues watching this virtual event via Zoom. My name is Manveer Sandhu, Director of Winemaking at Rack & Riddle Custom Wine Services. And my thoughts are with everyone who are dealing with the circumstances we face this year. It has been a difficult year with the pandemic and wildfires, but I'm incredibly proud of my family, friends, colleagues, and my community for the strength and resilience they have shown throughout 2020. We've been adjusting to the new reality due to the spread of COVID-19, but there's promise in the future. Our community has resolve, our community is strong, and we will get through this together. Thank you and stay safe.
Congratulations, Manveer and Rack & Riddle. Our next award winner is Juan Pablo Torres Padilla, who's a winery manager and partner for Napa County at Sullivan Rutherford Estate in Rutherford. He was first exposed to wine at a very young age, growing up in Mexico. His father, grandfather traveled the world extensively. As a teenager, he would pour him a small glass and share his passion for Bordeaux, Burgundy, and California wines. During one very special private visit to Domaine de la Romanée-Conti in Burgundy, I think I got that right, with a co-owner there, his uncle and he were inspired to transform their passion for wine into a life project. The idea of owning a winery had been planted. The search started in Bordeaux and Burgundy, but soon turned to the Napa Valley due to the blend, and this is important, we've been hearing about this all evening, blend between the tradition and deep history of the old world and the innovative, disruptive search for excellence. It's the culture of the U.S. What changes have you noticed in your industry in the last 5 years? During his time in the Napa Valley, he's already seen several trends come and go, but the world's iconic wines remain timeless, and their mission is to be at the forefront of innovation and quality while also staying authentic to the classical winemaking traditions. Humanity has made wine for the past 9,000 years by honoring the terroir of Rutherford and our property's 200-acre history in the Napa Valley, while also employing modern farming and innovative wining techniques. They aim to make truly memorable wines. How has the pandemic impacted your business? We were already in the process of elevating our hospitality experience and thus accelerated it in the wake of the pandemic. Finally, for instance, they've started a chef series to create unique recipes to pair with their current wine releases. And as wineries opened for outdoor tastings, they began to host guests in outdoor areas. Finally, he says, we've seen this crisis as an opportunity to innovate and create new and unique standards of excellence in hospitality. Sounds like they will emerge from this stronger than ever. Congratulations to Juan Pablo Torres Padilla of Sullivan Rutherford Estate. Congratulations.
Hi, my name is Juan Pablo, or JP, and I am truly humbled for being one of the recipients of this North Bay Business Journal Award. I feel extremely privileged and thankful for having one of the greatest teams here in Napa Valley at Sullivan Rutherford Estate. I want to thank them for being part of this great endeavor of making wine. And I truly believe here in California, we have that perfect blend between an old world tradition of making wine. Humanity has been making wine for 9,000 years, which is huge. So that blend of old world tradition and new world tradition of an innovative, creative, disruptive spirit of always making things better, which is truly a great combination. So I feel extremely privileged of being able to participate in this community of winemaking in California. Thank you, North Bay Business Journal. And I look forward in the new year to sharing a glass or probably several glasses of wine with many of our colleagues. Thank you.
Well, congratulations once again. Our next award goes in the head distiller category to Tim Welch, who's the head distiller at Moylan's Distilling Company in Petaluma. He was hired as an apprentice in 2011 And there they began making a number of products for clients, as well as whiskey for himself and the owners. After a few years, as the whiskey began to mature, they have put more focus on it. How has your company influenced the industry in the last 5 years and key accomplishments? They have worked with other micro distilleries, helping them get off the ground over the years. They've also helped launch multiple craft spirits brands, and the idea being that the craft world will help each other. We have over 40 gold medals, as well as best in class awards and best in show and various prestigious competitions. What changes have you noticed in your industry? We make a world-class small batch whiskey that won't break the bank. We think of it as a new world whiskey that based on our competitive achievements, a lot of larger distilleries could charge a lot more or would charge a lot more money for. How have you responded to challenges and opportunities in the pandemic? At the beginning of the pandemic, we started working with local breweries and distributors to procure beer as it expired at closed restaurants and the warehouses. We've reclaimed the alcohol from the beer and turned it into sanitation spray with the FDA and WHO requirements, and he donated a majority of the sanitizer to local essential businesses. Wow, congratulations and thank you. Please join us and our co-hosts in congratulating Tim Welch of Moylan's Distributing Company. It's now my pleasure to introduce Michelle Osborne as a partner at BPM to present the next award. Michelle?
It is my pleasure to present a 2020 Wine Award to Sarah and Josh Opatz, co-founders of award-winning Young and Yonder Spirits. Young and Yonder is an artisan craft distillery that was discovered in a small warehouse in Cloverdale in 2013. They develop, market, and sell high-quality spirits, including vodka, gin, and bourbon. Before starting Young and Yonder, Sarah and Josh were working in San Francisco in graphic design and finance, respectively. It was just a matter of time before they followed a path similar to Josh and his parents in viticulture and winemaking to pursue their passion with distilled spirits. They love the variety of spirits and flavors and enjoy the challenge and technical skill required to develop a high quality and wide range of distilled spirits. In their Healdsburg tasting room, the Opatzes offer exceptional customer service and an approachable and educational tasting experience that builds brand loyalty and engagement. Please join me in congratulating Sarah and Josh Opatz and Young and Yonder Spirits.
Hi everyone, my name is Josh. I'm one of the co-founders of Young and Yonder Spirits here in Healdsburg. We're honored for the recognition by the North Bay Business Journal for the hard work we've put forth this year. This year's been difficult for many of us on many different levels, ourselves notwithstanding. While we haven't been able to see a lot of you this year because our tasting room has been closed, we really do appreciate the outpouring of support that we've had from our local North Bay business community and beyond. I think what makes us special in North Bay is that we have a sense of community. We appreciate hard work and we support small independently owned businesses like ourselves. And I hope that through all this, we can continue the tradition of ensuring that our local economy maintains and recovers so as we move forward to brighter days ahead. So on a personal note, I hope that all of you are doing the best you can to stay healthy, support your local economies and your local communities, and staying optimistic for better times ahead. So on that note, cheers to you and the future, and thank you for your continued support.
Well, congratulations to Josh and Sarah. What a great message. We all, right now, and when we come out of this, we really have to support each other. So thank you, Michelle, for presenting that award. So we're down to the final two, and it's my pleasure to present the next award for winery CEO, Director of Winemaking for a large winery, to Chrissy Whitman, who's Director of Winemaking at the Prisoner Wine Company in St. Helena. Working in the wine industry hadn't actually been her original intent when she enrolled in California, Cal Poly as a physical education major, but ultimately switching her major and receiving a Bachelor of Science in Ecology and Systemic Biology. And her first peek into the wine world came while she was working as an independent environmental chemistry lab and was asked to fill in for a coworker in the wine division. And that experience really piqued my interest, she said. And 2 years later, she became a wine chemist at Meridian and later was promoted to laboratory enologist. Not too long after that, she realized further education, so she returned to Cal Poly to pursue an MS while working as a lab manager and production winemaker at Courtside Cellars. And once she received her degree, she hit the ground running and got some pivotal career-shaping experience at Chai Vineyards and Wild Horse Winery in Vineyards, and officially joined Prisoner Wine Company as director of winemaking in 2016. It's been such an exciting experience that has really allowed her to grow as a winemaker. She said, their number one namesake wine, the Prisoner Red Blend, anchors their portfolio, have consistently remained the number one luxury red blend, and really resurging the public's interest in that category. Beyond the Prisoner, their winemaking team works hard to continually create new innovative blends and varietals. Another standout accomplishment was opening their tasting lounge in 2018, which was a game changer for Napa Valley. And their goal for the space was to create a home for the brand that physically embodies its untraditional, edgy, and artistic nature, which she said, I think we did. It was really thrilling to offer this new contemporary space. What changes have you noticed in the industry in the last 5 years? Looking at the success of the Prisoner and the large portfolio of blends, she's noticed consumers are more adventurous and willing to try new things. How has the pandemic affected their business? And what has been the impact? Our team's number one priority is health and safety of our staff and guests. So we've been abiding, of course, by the safety rules. The online business has been booming due to the overall caution around shopping in person. And they're seeing great growth across their wines sold on their website and e-commerce platforms such as Drizzly. What adjustments and initiatives do you think we'll have to make once we get past the pandemic, and why? We'll likely continue some of our virtual offerings even after the pandemic. Our virtual tastings and pairing videos allow us to connect with fans around the world who can't travel to the winery in person. I've heard that several times in talking to wine leaders. The virtual pivot has allowed fans to experience the winery for the first time, just in a more modern way, she told the Business Journal in her profile. Congratulations to Chrissy Whitman, the Prisoner. Chrissy?
Hi, my name is Chrissy Whitman. I'm director of winemaking for the Prisoner Wine Company. Well, this has been one heck of a year. I mean, that's to say the least. Man, through it all though, our community of growers, friends, industry friends, coworkers, and patrons, we will come out better and stronger. Hard to believe that, right? But really, the bottom line is that we will continue to support each other the best we can and move forward. Know that these times are certainly building a lot of character. Thank you, Wine Industry Network and North Bay Business Journal, for this honor. Everybody, please stay safe and have a happy holiday.
Congratulations, Chrissy. I love that message that we're building character during this time. And I think she's absolutely right that we just have to change the way we treat the world and treat others as we go forward. So congratulations again. To present the final award, I want to please welcome Hema Quinn of Comerica to present again this final award this evening. Hema?
Wine Shipping is the largest DTC logistics provider for alcoholic beverages, providing critical tools for storage, transport, and order fulfillment. Headquartered in the Napa Valley, Wine Shipping has a national presence with 2.2 million square feet of warehouse space across 5 strategic regions. Despite the name, Wine Shipping does a great deal more than simply ship wine. They are a full-service logistics partner, providing inventory management, storage, business analytics, and transportation services to their beverage brand customers, which consist of wine, beer, and spirit manufacturers. Due to the COVID pandemic, the wine industry has been hit hard, specifically with on-premise sales as the result of bar and restaurant closures. However, the direct-to-consumer sales are up as more and more people are choosing to enjoy wine at home during the lockdown. Wine Shipping has seen these results in the form of increased shipment volumes, So have been laser focused on meeting that demand as they brace for the biggest holiday shopping season in history. With online sales being the new normal for wine and the unlikelihood that they'll drop back down to pre-pandemic levels, e-commerce is a mega trend that was already transforming the industry. Technology is making more wines available to consumers wherever they may be, and wine shipping will continue to be there for their customers, offering solutions that help them rise to the occasion. I am pleased to congratulate wine shipping on this 2020 Suppliers Award.
Well, thank you, Hema. At this point, I'd like to welcome Eric Lewis to make a live comment about his award. Eric, thank you for being with us.
Thank you very much. First of all, we're really flattered and honored to be a recipient of this award. I'm really proud of the team here at Wine Shipping. We have a great team, and this year they've really done an incredible job. They know that the stakes are high, and they asked me to share with you that we're here as your partner and that we appreciate everything you do, as well as your confidence in us. That said, the team's efforts this year are delivering one of the smoothest peak shipping seasons while we're shipping at record volumes. And this has given us great confidence for the year ahead. As has been said many times, 2020, it's been a make or break year for many in many industries, including ours. And we plan to be part of the reason that we all make it. So thank you for that.
Thank you, Eric, and thank you for being, in the right place at the right time and with the right ethic, I guess you could call it, to serve customers in a time of really incredible need. So that concludes our awards. I want to thank all of our presenters here, and once again, a virtual round of applause to all our recipients. I said at the beginning, it was an exceptional year in terms of nominations and winners. So thank you again. I want to thank our supporters here, our sponsors. A special thanks to the Wine Industry Network and Spirited Magazine, our presenting sponsors, BPM and Frank Family Vineyards, and finally, Comerica Bank for coming in as our underwriter. They've made this possible to be free to all of our participants here today. Congratulations again to everyone. Have a great holiday and stay safe. We'll all get through this together. Thanks so much. Congratulations.